Hello everyone, and good morning for those who have morning time, and for those in Asia, actually this is a program just for you to be, or to give you a chance to have a live chat together. And as you know, I care really special care for people who they are in Asia, like Indonesia and Malaysia and etc. and Philippines. So they can be with us because always our time is different, and you know, they don't get a chance really to be with us usually. Today, our topic, as you see, is something always we hear from Muslims, that you Christians, you lie about Islam. And the funny, we show them every day in the screen with the reference, we show them what we are talking about, we give the reference, we give the hadith number, we give the Quran verse, we give the interpretation, yet they say, you lie. And I found that this is a sign of not only a sign, it's kind of a that's it. They submit. They cannot answer. It's a act of submission that Islam cannot be defended. I saw somebody, he sent me a video of Abdul. He is saying that the Christian prince, he lied when he said that the prophet, his body consumed. Why? Because some Islamic books saying that the prophet, when he died for 3 days, he stink, his nails became green, blue, his belly became full of fart. And, you know, those are not our Islamic website. However, the Muslim, they say, oh, those are weak hadith. You know, well, for sure you will say it's a weak hadith because those prove Muhammad to be a false prophet. The question is, if this is not true, why you Muslims, who they are Muslims, who they are good Muslims, why they say that about your prophet? So, you can claim as you want. This is Ibn Abbas, the cousin of Muhammad. He says, the messenger of Allah, or Ibn al-Abbas, the messenger of Allah, Allah pray on him and salute him. يَأْسَنُ كَمَا يَأْسُنُ الْبَشَرِ. He stink like human, they stink. So if he die, and now he die, so bury your friend. Are you going to make him die twice? Which means he's suffering now from not burying him. So the only solution, the reason the Muslims, they say that this is a weak story, simply because that proved that Muhammad is a false man. However, as long you insist that Muhammad's body was not consumed, what about you take it out from the grave right now and let billions of people see an amazing miracle of Allah? And I assure you, a lot of people will convert to Islam. Actually, why you even bury him? If the body of Muhammad will not consumed ever, if you take him now from the grave, based on this hadith, as Muhammad, he said, that's mean Muhammad's body should be exactly the same as he used to be when he was alive. Why you bury him? Why you need to bury a body which nothing can hurt it? You see, when you say that a ground cannot eat our body, that's mean even animals cannot do that because you have Allah protection. That's it. You know, obviously, Muhammad is saying that I am not a human being like anyone. And he is saying that we, the prophet, we are different kind of people. Yes, we have a flesh like you, but our flesh is not like you. Yes, we eat, we drink, but we are not like you. And the funny, the Muslim, they say to us that they believe in this hadith. And this is a sahih hadith. But isn't it the Quran says that everything, including a human, they die and they will consume? So which one, you Muslims, you take? The funny, they say to you that we Muslims, if there is something against the Quran, we don't accept. Well, isn't it, this is against the Quran? Isn't it this even against the hadith itself? which is a sahih hadith. Which means the same one who says to you that human body, his body will be decay and nothing will stay of him, is the same one he is saying to you that the body of the human, like me, who is a prophet, will not be consumed by death. The Quran says, let us go to the yellow pages of Muhammad. Please invite your friends. And today we are going to answer, you know, many questions Muslims they come with. Everything in the face of the earth is going to be destroyed. Let us see some reference. Actually, all the verses speaking about the judgment day, it says it clearly that everything will be destroyed and everything will be burned, blah 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 blah. And yet the Muslim they say to us that Muhammad, obviously, he is, you know, he is not a human being. He is a person who his body will not be consumed. And not only that, Muhammad, when he claimed that his body will not be consumed, he claimed that he is God, because you see, this is when he said to them, pray on Friday and say your salah. The Muslim in their translation, they say this is mean blessing, as you see. And this is the same lie we always hear from Muslims when they say a blessing. This is what the word salah mean. But we explain that this is will be even more problematic for Muslims, because if Allah and the angels and the Muslims can do blessing, that means Allah is just one of us. That means we are equal to Allah in sending blessing. Only God can bless. This is was a salah, a supplication asking for something. That is salah. So here you will see Muhammad, not only he claimed that his body will not decay, he is saying that the prayer of the Muslims is going to be displayed in the front of him. Which means Muhammad, he claimed that he is God, yet he is dead in the flesh, but he's alive. Look what he said. The Messenger of Allah said, the best day, the best of your days is a Friday. On it, Adam was created. So Muhammad, he claimed that Adam was created in Friday, which, by the way, very silly, because if this is what if the day where Adam was created, and this is the last day, so why you Muhammad don't follow the Sabbath? Because you just admitted that the Sabbath was the day where God, he finished his work. So why you are taking Friday as a holiday, but yet the Quran says in many verses that Allah, he cursed the Jews for breaking the Sabbath. And then he said that, pray on me in that day especially. And here they say, they translate the word prayer as a blessing. So do prayer upon me on that day, for your piece of prayer, not blessing, will be presented on me, to me. Okay, who are you? How Muhammad is dead, but yet he's alive. So you Muslims, by confirming this, you confirm that you claim that Muhammad is God. And here you see the sign of hypocrisy or not a sign, I mean clear evidence of hypocrisy. They keep saying to us Muhammad is just a slave of Allah, but yet Muhammad, he is dead in the grave, and all the prayer of 1.4 billion Muslims is going to present in front of him. How he can read it? How a human being, he have the ability to review the prayer of 1.4 billion? What computer even can do it? There's no way Muhammad, he can do that unless he is God. So he is dead, but he's alive. He is dead, but his body will not consumed. His body, he's dead, but he can see and he can hear. He is dead, but the angels will bring the salah of every Muslim, and he will listen to it one by one. A clear sign of worshiping Muhammad. You Muslims are pagan who worship a man. His name is Muhammad, and this is the truth. And this is our challenge. Not only Muhammad, he confirmed that his body will not be consumed. Look what he said. He said, Allah forbidden the earth to consume the body of the prophets. That's mean you Muslims should show us the body of all the prophets. Here we go. They will not be consumed. So we should find Adam. According to Islam, Adam is a prophet. We should be able to find the Musa's. I mean, all the Muslim, they have 124,000 prophet. 124,000. Can't you find me one? Here we go. The grave of your prophet is there. Go grab him and take him from the grave for 2 hours. Let everybody see in the world how his body is preserved. And let us see if Islam is a lie or not. Will take you 5 minutes, everybody will see. And if Muhammad, his body is pretty preserved as you claim, I assure you a lot of people will convert to Islam, because obviously this is a miracle. This is an extreme miracle. A person who died 1,400 years ago, his body is still the same as he died. Not only is not cannot consumed, Muhammad is saying that it's forbidden. That's it. It's mean like nothing can touch us. Our body will stay as it is. Then we find the Muslims who they are smarter from the other Muslims. They have articles to the other Abdul Muslims. The articles, as we see, those by Muslims saying, how in the world we can believe in such a garbage? That the body of the prophet was not consumed. Refuting the falsehood of the prophet, dead body never consumed. Now, who is the one who's talking? This is Islamic website, Ahlul Quran, the people of the Quran. Those are Muslims, and this is the writer. All of those are his articles. This is your Muslim friend, Muslim Sheikh, whatever you call him. All right. So he is saying, how, you know, he's answering the fool. He's answering the fool. How in the world we can believe in such a garbage? There are three, there's major narrators of the so-called hadith, i.e. saying, ascribe falsely to the Prophet Muhammad decayed after his death, blah, 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 blah. Okay, okay, so he's, now, this is what is the problem here. Many people are saying that Muhammad, you know, he died and his body is consumed, and other Muslims, they refuse this. They say this is a weak story. You notice here that the Muslims are trying to refute the Muslims who say, no, Muhammad, his body did not decay. His body was not consumed. And he is showing them reference one after one, saying, here we go, this is cannot be true, because this is even against the Quran. However, we always notice that anything will make Muhammad look like a liar, immediately it's called hadith weak, false, a lie. But guess what? Who is the one who wrote the hadith? It's a good Muslim. Why a good Muslim? He was even, why even the Muslim, they consider his story to have it in their books. If he is a bad Muslim, no, because he's a good Muslim. He's a good Muslim who said a story about Muhammad, and yet now, because now people, they start asking questions. For 1400 years, nobody dared to ask question. Who dare to question this? The books is there, the disasters are there, but nobody dare to ask a question. So we don't have a problem with that hadith or this story or that story. But now, because people are asking questions, and the only way immediately to refute something we cannot refute is to say this story is a lie. Right? So when the Muslims, they confirm in their articles, they have two opposition articles, one saying Muhammad no, he decay, and those are the people who reject the stupidity of the hadith, because they think that the Quran is this is stupid, but the fact the Quran is more stupid. And there's those who worship the hadith of Muhammad because he is their God, and we will prove it in the coming topic. They say no, the Prophet, he said the truth, and the Prophet body will not be consumed. Now, there's a person who sent a question to a Christian a lady. She sent me this message in Skype, and she said this guy, he gave me this verse from the Bible, and this is a verse about stoning to death of people who committed adultery. And he's saying to her, how in the world your book teach that? I mean, this is one of the funny thing about Muslims. As I say, the Muslim is the same as a camel. He do not know what is in his book. He do not know what is his prophet is about. You're a prophet, my friend. He was trying all his life to be a Jew, but he failed all his life. Now, if we show you that what the Jews, they practice of stoning to death, Muhammad, he stole it from them, what you will do then? How you can complain about something, supposedly you're a prophet, he took it from the Jews, and you Muslim, you practice it? That because Muslims are ignorant, they are copy-paste. Somebody said to them, look what the Jews, they teach in their book, that if a man, they committed adultery, then we have to stone him to death. Okay, if this is bad, then why your prophet, he took it? Same time here, you will see Muhammad, how he stole even from the book of the Jews, that you have to have witnesses. And those witnesses have to be trustworthy. This is exactly what we find in the Quran. But in the Quran today, we have the witnesses is a must, but we don't have the stoning to death verses. Why? Because the goat ate it. If you remember, let us see. All right. The stoning death to death, the verse of stoning and breastfeeding adult 10 times was revealed, and the paper was under my pillow. When the Messenger of Allah died, we were preoccupied with his death, and a tam sheep came and ate it. I'm happy for you, tam sheep, but we are not happy now, because now we are missing very important verses, especially about the breastfeeding for adult 10 times, which is the most stupid thing ever I heard about in any cult in the world, that the Prophet of God, he ordered women to give their breast to strange men so they can suck it in 10 different time until they are satisfied in 10 different days. And this is why I don't like goats no more, since this goat, she did that to us, because now we are missing the verse so we can love more. And by the way, I don't believe in the story about the verse of, the goat ate it. I don't think the goat ate it. I think Aisha ate it. I think the Muhammadan ate it. I mean, okay, the goat ate the verse, but the goat did not eat the Muslims. You see, do you remember when the Sheikh Abdul Wadud, he called me and he said, we, the Quran is preserved in our chest. Do you remember? I said, okay, here we go. I want you to recite those verses for me. As long as the Quran is preserved in your chest, show me what is inside your chest. Show me. Silence me. Huh? What he said to me, he said, brother, you have any questions? Later. He ran away. The Quran is not preserved. A goat ate the Quran, and Allah can do nothing about it. And now the Muslim cannot recite for us the verse of his breastfeeding for adult. or the verse of stoning, which some of them it says a sheikh or a sheikha, etc. But you know, they don't know really what they are talking about. But as you see, you are complaining about what is written in the book of the Jews of stoning to death, but your prophet was copying from the Jews and he claimed that this was a verse given to him from Allah. Ignorant, claiming to have knowledge, and they have a questions. What about Omar? He complained about, we cannot find this verses no more. What about your prophet ordering people to do stoning? As long as this is something the Jews, and you don't like what the Jews teach, why your prophet copying what the Jews they have? As you see, your prophet here is talking to the Jews, and he know what the Jews they have of a stoning to death verse in their Bible. Omar said, I am afraid that after a long time has passed, people may say, we do not find the verses. Hold on, did he say verses? So how many verses are missing? And why we don't have them? Here we go, Omar is still alive. If Omar remember them, why he don't put them in the Quran? Our brother, our Quran is preserved. Is it Omar who said that the Quran was 1,000, 1,025,000, or 27,000 letter? Which means the Quran today is not even 20% of the real Quran? Isn't it Aisha who said that the chapter of Al-Baqarah used to be equal to the chapter of Al-Ahzab, which means there's more than 200 verses are missing in one chapter alone? So a Muslim complain about what is written in the Torah, but as you see, they practice what is written in the Torah, which we cannot find in the Quran. And the funny, they say to us, we do not practice something against the Quran. The whole Quran doesn't say stone to death. The Quran says different. The Quran never mentioned, actually, what do you do if it is married or single? Let us see. Chapter 24, verse number 2. Why Allah did not, if the Quran is a perfect book, why he don't say fornicators who they are singles, we scourge them 100 stripe? Why he don't say that? Why he did not add the word single? What he would lose if he used the word single? So now this is can go for both. But if you ask Muslim scholars, they say no, this is only for single. If you are married, you will be stoned. Obviously, Muhammad is trying to follow the Jews. And the verse after that confirmed that. It says the fornicator shall marry none but fornicators, which mean that if a Muslim fornicate with a Muslimah, they have to marry each other if they are fornicators. They cannot marry from someone else. You marry each other. And this is yet still Muhammad trying to learn from the Jews, copying the Jews' law, and says, oh, this is the law of Allah. Then Muhammad, he came with the stoning to death. But as you see, the stoning to death verse is eaten by the goat. The goat was very angry. What we can do? The goat ate the verse in the book, but the goat did not eat 1.4 billion Muslims. So how come none of you can give us the verse and put it back in the Quran? Now we go to one more issue. Somebody sent me another question. Hold on. Yeah, this guy. This is a question sent to me in Skype. It was narrated from Rabia, blah, 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 that the messenger of Allah, he forbid the muta. Hold on. I mean, is that supposedly will make Muhammad look better or Muhammad and Islam look stupid? And what about the hypocrisy? How you say to us, we reject anything is against the Quran, but yet this is against the Quran. You see the hypocrisy? The Quran in chapter 4, verse 24 says you do muta. Hadith came and says we do not do muta no more. So which one we take? We take what contradict the Quran. So look at the hypocrisy of the Abdul. When they want anything contradict the Quran, we refuse. This is there's tons of hadith contradict the Quran, including the hadith about the body of the Prophet will not be consumed. We just mentioned 15 minutes ago. Secondly, what do you mean Muhammad, he engaged in muta and then he forbid muta? What kind of a prophet he is? What's wrong with him? Are you saying to me that your prophet decided to become decent? Is that what you mean? Otherwise, why he forbid it? If you say, like some of them, they try to give it a legitimate reason. They say, oh, this is during wartime. Well, still Muslims are in war. If this is during wartime, so still you can do it in war. Why you say it's forbidden for Judgment Day? What, people don't have war no more? Muslims have war everywhere. Have you ever seen a Muslim nation don't have war? So if the war is the reason for the muta, that means war is, here we go, we have war always. Since the time of Muhammad until now, the Muslims never stopped killing each other. So why he allowed the muta and why he forbid the muta? Allah, he allowed the muta, Muhammad forbid the muta. And Muhammad, but Muhammad himself, he practiced the muta. So here we notice that Muhammad is, according to Muslims, he is higher than Allah. If Allah, he allowed the muta, the Muslim don't care. Who care if Allah allow it or not? We follow Muhammad, we don't follow Allah. This is why the Quran says, وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولُ وَمَنْ أَطَاعَ الرَّسُولُ أَطَاعَ اللَّهُ. The one who obey the Prophet, the messenger, he obey Allah, not the opposite. If you remember when I asked Sheikh Abdul Wadud in our debate just 2 weeks ago, I asked him, how you obey a man? He's a sinner. He said to me, the Prophet is not a sinner. And then we showed him the verses in the Quran saying he is a big time sinner. If you ask any Muslim, is Muhammad a sinner or not? They will say, A'uzu billah, he's not. But the Quran confirmed he's a sinner. So how you say to me that you reject anything against the Quran, but you keep saying to me, Muhammad is not a sinner? Same time, if Allah allowed the muta and Muhammad later he forbid the muta, are you telling me that Allah was not a decent God in that moment when he made the muta halal? And Muhammad is fixing the mistake of Allah? In fact, yes, the hadith, it says here in front of us that the muta was forbidden, but there is many hadith says no, it was not. And this is an example. And this is sahih. It was reported from. Okay, he says, we have benefiting ourselves by the temporary marriage. By the way, this is not temporary marriage, this is muta. And we did perform sex contract temporarily during the lifetime of the Holy Prophet. Look, they call him holy. You see it? They call him holy. He's holy. He's God. And then during the time of Abu Bakr and during the time of Umar. Okay, how you say that Muhammad, he forbid the muta, but then you practice the muta during the time of Abu Bakr and Umar, which means after Muhammad. You see, when they say during the time of Abu Bakr, that's mean during when the time was Abu Bakr is the caliphate. This is after the death of Muhammad. It was the time of Abu Bakr. It was the time of Umar. And there was a time where Muhammad was alive. So here we go. It says we practice and we benefit ourselves from doing bang bang boom boom with any woman she take off her panty for $5. So how you say to me that the muta was forbidden and cancelled? Are you going to say to me this hadith is sahih or weak, or you play the game of shish kebab, falafel, hummus? This is sahih Muslim. What we will do with it? I know what we will do with it. You know, right away, so what if it's sahih Muslim? We should say it's weak. I mean, come on. From now, let us say it, it's weak. Not only weak, it's garbage. It's rejected. But here we notice that Muhammad is a person who creates fiction law to fit with his agenda. He have men, they are horny, and he don't care. Muhammad, he don't care for anything. It's called ethic. What he care for is how he accomplish his mission to be a king, to be rich, to rape women, to have a glory for his own, a glory of a war lord who want to conquer and take every woman from her husband, to rape her, to take the money, to take the wealth. And that's why we see tons of stories speaking about Muhammad torturing people to steal their money, torturing a Jewish man to tell him where he hide his money. Tell us where you hide your money. Where is the money? This is Muhammad. Let's see if we can find you the reference in English. Let us see. And for sure, you know, they will say we don't accept this hadith, right? Anything. And look here, by the way, look here, Muhammad making a false prophecy that in the Euphrates, in the Euphrates River, there is a gold, mountains of gold. Where? In the Euphrates River. The Euphrates shall soon uncover. Soon, do you see the word soon? Now, what we will do is that da'if? No, it is not da'if, it's sahih. So your prophet is a false prophet. Soon, mountains of gold will appear in the Euphrates River. And not only that, he says that nobody will take money from it. Nobody will take the gold. Why? Because people will became so wealthy there. Do you see it? Guys, according to Muhammad, very soon, actually in Arabic it says extremely soon, not only soon, it says yushik. Yushik, it's like, it's something like almost is going to happen, like now. Like maybe 5 minutes from now. Yushiku. Yushiku al-furata an yahsur ala kanzi min dhahab. فَمَنْ حَضَرُهُ فَلَا يَأْخُذُ مِنْهُ شَيْءٍ. The Euphrates extremely soon will uncover a treasure of gold. God knows how much gold. But nobody will take because nobody wants it. You are right. Throw an ounce of gold in the street in Egypt or in Pakistan, and let us see how nobody will throw a dollar in the floor. So all the Muslims, they have, you know, they have their own fictions about their prophet, and all the fictions Muhammad he create about himself, about his prophecy, prove to us that Muhammad is a false man. Let us see. Like, this website is hard to find. Anyway, if we could not find it, if we could not find it in English, we can find it in Arabic anyway. Here we go. This is the book of the Seerah. And this is how Muhammad, he raped the woman. Her name is Safiya, who is a Jewish woman. And then they found that there's a guy, you know, he is going around. His name is Kunana. He is going around and like a ruin, a place which nobody live in it. Like, you know, in Arabic, we call it khurba, which means like a place, maybe a destroyed house or an old house. So they suspect something. So the prophet, he ordered to bring him to arrest him. And they torture him in order to know where is the money. What money? The money of the Jews. Why you take their money? Because Muhammad is a thief. You see, all those are reference for the story. And here, actually, this is a sheikh. He is explaining how the prophet was torturing a man to get the money of the Jews. This is what Islam is about. And you notice always, when something looks stupid, the smart one of them, he deny it, but in a, they try to play a game, like those guys who don't accept the hadith. You know, did you ask yourself why some Muslims don't accept hadith? The answer is very simple. They are ashamed of it. As simple as that. It's not because really they don't believe in it. But this hadith, the prophet's story, is bringing shame to Islam. So the only way we can protect Islam to say we don't believe in the hadith. Anytime something make Muhammad look stupid, they say we don't accept it. Even if it is very sahih. Like this one. Where the prophet here, he is playing as Dr. Mr. Bean, claiming that the woman, she have a sperm, it is thin and yellow, and the man, he have a sperm, is thick and white, and whichever of them comes first, the child will resemble the parent. A smart Muslim, he will say, there's no way the prophet will say such a stupid thing. So what he do? He reject what is accepted for centuries and centuries and 1400 years. He throw it under his feet because this is very embarrassing and it's very stupid. But it's sahih. So what we will do now? The only way to do something about it, to say we don't accept all of this, that's it, sahih or not, we don't care. So when the Muslims say that the Christians are lying about Islam, the fact it is your prophet lying to you, it is you lying to yourself, you decide to go in denial, you don't want to listen, to read, to see in what is in front of you, written in front of you, said by your prophet, in order to protect and preserve fiction religion. A God who promised me women who have no, you know, I can see the marrow of their bones. Like, I like bones for soup, but I will see the women. This is Sahih Bukhari. What do you say to me? Are you going to say to me this is weak? Huh? What we will do with this? We will be in heaven and we will have women who their body is an X-ray bones. I cannot wait. I cannot wait to go to the heaven of Muhammad so I can see those women. Obviously, they are very special. They must be very sexy. I mean, who can deny that? Who can reject this? So now, if I am a Muslim, who is a person who went to school, who educated himself, I have a degree in shish kebab, falafel, hummus, and then I see my prophet saying in the heaven, Allah promised me this. So what I will do? There's one of two choices. Either I will say this hadith is false, but this hadith is approved by billions of Muslims. Scholars, non-scholars, dummy, smart. But we cannot accept it. This is stupid. The same as the prophet saying that the women, she have a sperm coming. But okay, what we would do now with the Quran? What we would do with the Quran? Are we going to say the Quran is stupid too? Isn't it the Quran speak and state that the woman, she have a sperm, and even the sperm is coming from her ribs? So, okay, we get away by saying we don't believe in the hadith. Are we going to say we don't believe in the Quran too? Trust me, they are already saying we don't believe in the Quran. During my, you know, my long journey debating Muslims, I heard tons of time Muslims saying we don't believe in this Quran. This Quran is already fabricated. There's no way Allah will say this. So what they do, they play a different stage of games. Now, supposedly, Allah is a true God. The Quran is a true book of Allah, but not this one. And it's specifically those verses, because obviously they are stupid. And then you will see a smart Muslim. He go and says to us, and this is how they pick up their cherries. As an example, you see, a Muslim, he says to me, oh, you said the prophet, he did bow down to the idols, and you said that this is mentioned in Ibn Kathir. Yes, it's mentioned in Ibn Kathir. In English, we cannot find it. In Arabic, it's there. And we made videos about it. Read for me Ibn Kathir. Okay, can I read for you Ibn Kathir about this one? He says, no, I don't want it. Why? Because Ibn Kathir, he is stupid like my prophet. This is Ibn Kathir. Confirming what is in the Quran. A gushing fluid proceeding from between the backbone and the ribs, the backbone of the man and the ribs of the woman. So Quran teach. This is Quran now. This is not hadith. That the man, he have a sperm coming from his backbone. Well, nice to meet you, backbone. Look like Allah, he never heard of something called testicles. And I don't think he will ever even hear about it. It's a fluid. It is yellow and fine in texture. He's talking about what? He's talking about the women fluid. According to Muhammad, the fluid, which is the woman she see in her private part when she is having sex, this is what will make the baby. And this fluid is coming from her location of the necklace, not only the ribs. The location of the necklace at Tara'ib is not only a word near ribs, no. It is the location where the two bones in the top of your ribs meet. Where exactly, if you have a short necklace, is going to lay down in your neck. And then he says here, and the child will not be born except from both of them, i.e. the sexual fluid. Do you see it? The ribs of the women. So now we say we don't accept the hadith. We don't. So what about the Quran? What about the Quran saying that the sperm will become a congealed blood? So when a Muslim, he always say, we don't accept this, we don't accept that. He is talking about not accepting Islam, actually. He's not about saying, maybe that he says to you, you are lying, but the fact, as you see, this is their books. And when they want Ibn Kathir is a scholar, when they want Ibn Kathir is an idiot. And by the way, Ibn Kathir, he did not explain the Quran. He made his book just to answer the Christians who are around him in Syria. Those people there are educated, the Christians in those countries. They are the Aramaic people. They are very smart. All right, Mark Cleveland. Anyway, guys, we are going to keep it we will finish for now. Actually, I did this video just specifically to be with those who live in Asia, like in Indonesia, etc., so they can be with us in the chat. And please download my videos. As you see, I don't keep them. And the reason I don't keep my videos, even though that will make I have a lower subscription, etc., but I want to be sure that people are downloading my videos and posting them all over. And don't forget to subscribe to the website you see in the front of you, minds.com, Christian Prince. Let us flash it here for you so you can see it. All right? Minds.com. Always before I go live, I post there. It's better than YouTube. It's more stable. You know, we don't trust YouTube. We don't trust Twitter. They can ban you anytime, and bingo, you are gone. This is why I have many accounts in order to, you know, to... because you know the topic you are speaking about is very sensitive, and there's people they are brew Islam, you know, all of us. This is why you see them are united. I mean, it's funny how you see the liberals are united with those who hate them most. This is what it's called, like this, when the stupid decide to make love. He make love to the wrong person. So Islam and liberals now in bed together. Twitter, YouTube, they defend Islam. Google, if you go in Google right now, you search, you find only positive things about Islam, and you will see negative things like hiding, like rarely you will see it right away appearing. Type the word foolish, you will see right away the word Trump come in the top. Why? Trump is foolish. If foolish became a president, that's really funny. If this is what foolish is about, I want to be foolish too. I want to be foolish like him and own billions, so I can open TV stations to get a Muhammad busted day and night. I want to be foolish like him so I can be a president. If this is foolish, who is the smart then? So the propaganda is always sponsored by the devil, and it is you who lie, not us. We show you everything in the screen. The Muslim, they keep saying to me, show me your face. Why? Because they don't want me to show in the screen what I have in the screen. They want somebody just to give a speech. But showing in the screen is extremely harmful. Right? They prefer to see somebody showing his face, but not somebody saying the stupidity of the Quran and the Hadith and their prophet. Just show us your face. Be a man, show us your face. Don't show us how stupid our prophet is. And what about you ask your God the same question, show us your face. Allah in the judgment day is going to show you his shin. Shin worshipper. You refuse Jesus to be God, for he is a man. You accept your God to be a shin. Have you ever heard of religion like this? How we will recognize Allah? How? From his shin, my friend. MashaAllah, the shin of Allah. Let's see where the hadith. The shin of Allah. Here we go. I'm so sure that you Muslims, you will be so proud and so excited when you see Allah doing the striptease show. Allah will come to them in different shape. Read with me carefully. Then the Almighty will come to them in a shape. Allah have a shape. Well, yeah, Allah is a shape. Allah is a physical being. 99% of the Abdul do not know that their God Allah is a physical being. He is not a spirit and he has no spirit. You believe it or not? You will see a guy, he is 60 years old, going to the mosque every Friday, bowing down, up and down, up and down. Yet you ask him, is Allah is a physical being or not? He says, no. Is Allah have a spirit or not? He says, he have a spirit. But in fact, both answers are wrong. Allah is a physical being and Allah has no spirit and he is not a spirit. So Allah will come to them in a shape other than the one which they know and saw first time. When the Muslim they saw Allah first time, is that Jesus? Or this is Muhammad? When you saw them first time. And he will say, I am your Lord. They will say, you are not our Lord. And none will speak to him. He will go, the Muslim, they will spit at Allah and they will kick his bum. Get lost. You are not our Allah. Oh, I am Allah. No, we don't. Why? We don't, because they don't like his shape. They have a problem with his shape. This shape is not accepted. Come to us with something more sexy. I mean, come on. You want us to worship such a shape? Shape other than the one which we know or we saw first time. Look like Allah is coming in shape which look ugly. So now Allah, he have to do some adjustment. Otherwise, the Muslims will not approve him. So what Allah will do? The poor Allah, he go to his room, bedroom, and he change his shape. He start looking in the magazine. The shape of who? The shape of who? You know, he choose maybe an actor, which she have a nice body, wearing bikini, and he come back to the Muslims and he say to them, read carefully with me. And then the prophet says, but the prophet, and then it will be said to them, do you know any sign by which you can recognize him, which mean Allah? Okay, how we can recognize Allah? Guess what? By his shin. Allah will uncover his shin. Well, nice to meet you, Mr. Shin, King Chong Chong. So you spend the day saying a Christian worship a man, Christian, how do you worship Jesus? Christian, your God Allah is a shin and he is a shape and he changes shape. By the way, is your God Allah have any relationship with the Chinese guy, very famous, his name Ching Chong Chang, Nyong, Shin? Why Allah will show his shin? What about show his private part? I'm sure it's going to be more shiny. And how you can recognize him from his shin? I mean, how is that? How in the world anyone can believe in God and how we will recognize him, his shin? What? How? You tell me how. Do you have a special description of the shin? Is it so sexy? So now, like, imagine there's 1 billion ISIS watching Allah, and now Allah is stripping, slowly showing his shin, and they start like having orgasm, like, wow, so beautiful, so sexy. This is the shin of Allah. Come on, this is not the shin of a woman. This is Allah's shin. In different hadith, Muhammad, he says that Allah, he changed his shape and he come to them in other shape. Actually, the same story. And by the way, this hadith is sahih, so don't play the game of weak and strong. You know them. This is Sahih Bukhari. Bukhari. Because I know they will say to you, it's weak. It's a lie. Christians are lying. Hey, Farooq Ismail, you want me to call you? Farooq Ismail, give me your Skype. We have Farooq Ismail. He wanna talk to me. Let us see what Farooq Ismail wanna say. what is your name in Skype, Farooq Ismail? Hmm? Can you give me your name, please? You said to me, call me, right? Give me your name so I can call you. There we go. Now he played dead. When I did not notice his text, he was saying to me, call me. The second I said to him, okay, well, how I can call you, he is dead. Bingo. He's gone. Shish kebab. After I log off and close my Skype, suddenly all of them, they will become heroes, and Christian Prince is a liar. And by the way, there is somebody complained to me in Skype that there is some racist comment, and I warn anyone will make a racist comment in my program, not only I don't want you here, I will ban you. And even if you change your name and I know that you are the same person, we will ban you again and again. Racism is not welcome in Christianity, and we don't welcome anyone who is a racist. Racism against any, because racist, by the way, can be, they can be a black racist, you can be a white racist, you can be Asian racist. Anyone is racist, I believe he's a mentally ill person. Racism is a clear sign of mental illness. So anyone is a racist. You see, when we speak about Islam, we are not even talking about Muslims, we are talking about Islam. I don't hate Muslims, and I will never hate them. And Islam is not a race. Don't ever attack black people or Asian or even white. Racism is sign of your own problem. You have a problem, you are stupid, obviously. The same as Muhammad when he says that the most person Allah he hates is a black man. Or when he said that the black dog is a devil, because obviously he have a problem with the black color. So anyone he speak racism here, I spit on you, literally. I will not be even, if you give me donation, take your donation, get lost. We don't want it. If you have my books, burn it, throw it away. I met black people, they are 10 times better than my own people who they are white. I have a neighbor, I want to do shopping, my garage door did not close. He put a chair in front of my door for 2 hours sitting in the cold just to guard my house. I came back, I said, why you don't just hit the bomb and close the door? He said, I was afraid somebody will say he got in. Imagine. Never judge people by the cover of their book, right? That's what they say. Never judge people by ethnic group. There's bad, there's good everywhere. There's a criminal who they are white, there's a criminal who they are black. There's racist everywhere, there's garbage everywhere. Even in the same house, there's a sink. In the house, you have a sink, you have a garbage bag. You might find between your own family a person who don't present your family. So don't be stupid. And don't be driven by garbage. Don't be the same as Muhammad, who is obviously a racist. When we ask a Muslim why the most person Allah he hate is a black person, he have no answer. Why the devil is black? He don't have an answer. Why even the dog he's a devil if he's a black? He don't have an answer, because obviously it's nothing but hateful teaching against black people. And if you are doing that, you are no better than Muhammad, and you are no Christian. Me, myself, I don't like to associate with such people. See, this is one of the reasons, actually, I don't have too many Arab. I know they are, I can call them friends, because Arab are racist. If you sit between two Arabs and anyone walk by, right away they start talking, he's a Mexican, he is, etc. They are racist. They are 95% racism. This is their culture. Even if you are one of them, if you are not from a big family, they discriminate you. Even if you are one of them. And this is why Muhammad, he was proud about his family. He says, I am from etc. and my family is from etc. and etc. etc. and we are from the best of Bani Hashim. I am from the best. The Bani Hashim, the family of Hashim, are the best of mankind, and I am the best of mankind. He's a racist. Yet Muhammad, he says, if a person he is happy or proud about his family, tell him to go and bite the penis of his father or to suck the clitoris of his mother. Hypocrisy. Let us see if we can get Abdul Abdul Rashid. Okay, we have a guy, his name is Abdul Rashid. Answer, Abdul. Saying to me, call me, call me, and when we call them, they don't answer. Call me, call me. Okay, we called you. Let us call you again. Potato. So all the screaming for call me, for what, for what? You want to show your girlfriend that you challenge Christian Prince to call you? Or you want, you know, you want to show your four wives that you are a man? Hmm? You want to take a snapshot of your Skype to show her that I called Christian Prince, he did not answer me? You want to call me after I go offline? Hey, my wives, did you see what I did today? What you did by my husband, beautiful husband? I called the Christian Prince and the coward didn't answer. Let me show you a snapshot. Like once a Muslim, he was in my chat room. This is a long time ago in Pal Talk. He went to the Muslim room. He said, I was in a Christian Prince room and I humiliated him. I whipped the floor with him. A guy, he took the mic after him. He said, brother, I was there. And we saw what happened. Come on. We saw exactly what happened. Come on. It was the opposite. Anyway. You cannot answer us for a very simple reason. You are following the most stupid cult. What kind of a cult teacher he teach that the black dog is a devil? You tell me. Poor black dog. I mean, what's wrong? So what if he's a black? The black dog is a devil. The yellow dog is not. The white dog is not. The black cat is the devil. Muhammad, he says, وَقْتُلُ كُلَّ أَسْوَدٍ بَهِيمٍ. Kill every black animal. Any pure black animal should be killed. Why? Because he is the devil. I mean, obviously, your prophet is a true prophet. How he knew that the black dog is a devil? Come on. This, he must be. He must be from God. Let us see this guy again. Answer, Abdul. Okay, just get lost. I'm not going to call you no more, and I will block you. We thought you are a mosquito, you turned to be a fly. You can call me only if you are a Muslim. The only religion who believe even insects have religion is Islam. Even Allah in the judgment day is going to judge between two goats. Even goats are Muslims. Even monkeys are Muslims. Monkeys are ISIS too, not only Muslims. And they practice stoning to death. Do you see it? And a Muslim from the companion of the Prophet, he saw the monkeys stoning a female monkey for she committed illegal sexual relations, brother. I mean, have you ever heard of such a stupid religion like this? A monkey, she committed illegal sexual relationship, brother. Why she don't do muta? I mean, how stupid monkey, don't you know about the muta? Do muta. Go to the female, give her a banana, she take off her panty and halal. Don't just do sex, do muta. A monkey and doing illegal sexual, I mean, how ugly. I never saw that before. Imagine if we go to the zoo and we find monkeys wearing burqa. By the way, why monkeys, as long as they are Muslims, are not wearing burqa? Why a female monkey is showing her ass, my brother? I mean, don't you think this is haram? Shouldn't we enforce the Sharia law in the monkeys as long as they are Muslim, brother? Especially the monkeys who have red ass, chimpanzee. And you are telling me that Islam is not a religion of intelligence? What's wrong with you? How disgusting this monkey is, having illegal sexual relationship. Yeah, the baboon is a Muslim too. Don't call me right away. First, you have to tell me that you are a Muslim. And actually, you know, to avoid stupid kids calling, because usually we have some people, they are just calling to make fun and, you know, make noise. Give me, post something to me from your Skype, some from your Facebook. Text me in Facebook and I will call you myself. Just to check your Facebook to be sure that this is an official, someone here is not a kid, you know. Anyway, so as you see, this is a very stupid. Can they say this is a weak hadith? This is Sahih Bukhari. Sahih Bukhari. What we will do now? No, every Muslim, every animal is a Muslim according to Allah, supposedly. And supposedly, Muhammad is just a prophet, my friend. He did not say that. It's Allah who said that. You know? Well, why don't say weak Allah? Allah is weak. Muhammad is weak. Islam is weak. This is how stupid this religion is. They say to you that Allah protecting the Kaaba, but yet they are buying the AWACS of the American and the F-16. Well, why you need F-16 for Saudi Arabia? Allah protected. Al-Hajjaj, he destroyed the Kaaba. Al-Qurmuti, he destroyed the Kaaba and he took the black stone for more than 20 years and he was pissing on it. And then the Muslim, they have to bribe him in order to get the black stone back. They bribe him, literally. You give him money. He killed more than 10,000 around the Kaaba. And he was screaming, hey Allah, where is your birds? The one who appeared in the chapter of the elephant. Chapter of the elephant, yes. Why it's called chapter of the elephant? Because the Quran claimed an army of elephant came to destroy the Kaaba. Army of elephant can walk in the desert of Saudi Arabia. Have you ever heard of such a stupid story like this? How army of elephant they can go in the desert? An elephant cannot stay away from water. He need at least 600 gallon of water, and not only to drink, he have to keep his body wet, otherwise he will die. If you leave an elephant without water for one day, he's dead. Because they don't sweat, which means they cannot adjust their temperature. So this is why you see those animals, the same as the elephant, they jump all the day in the water during daytime in Africa. Or they go and hide inside the wood, under the shade of the trees. But to go to Saudi Arabia all the way to Mecca, where is no trees in the way, where is no water in the way, where is no rivers in the way, and you tell me an army of elephants, they came to destroy the Kaaba, and then we find Al-Qurmati destroying the Kaaba, killing more than 10,000, screaming in the middle of the Kaaba, saying, hey Allah, where is your bird? My friend, we challenged Mimi Hijab, we challenged his nurse, Ali Dawa, we challenged all those kids, we challenged them all, they are kids, and they run away. Go and see the videos. They are running away from me. Zakir Naik, all of them, they are kids. None of them is really, he's a person who have knowledge of what he's talking about. Those people are doing business. They are just kids. This guy, he kicked him out from the school. He was a teacher. He have no job. So he switched to be speaking corner, collect donation. He made a debate with David Wood. After 2 hours, he made a video. Who gave Allah alone? Did you hear it? He's singing, who gave Allah alone? He was quoting for them a verse from the Quran saying that Allah needs alone. Why? Because you want the Muslims to give him donation. It was a golden opportunity to make money. He did read for them those verses from the Quran. وَمَنْ الَّذِي يُقْرِضُ اللَّهُ Allah, he want a loan? And Allah is going to forgive you your sin if you give Mimi Hijab a donation? I should have changed my strategy to make people donate to me. Since when? Since when if you give somebody money, Allah forgive your sin? Is it obvious this is a scam? So if somebody now make a donation for me, my God will forgive your sin. Why? Are we bribing God? So he made the video, give us, brother, give us. We are the one who protect Islam. And he is doing exactly what Muhammad did, because this is what the verse coming from Muhammad. Muhammad, he was begging for money, promising Muslims that if you give me money, Allah will forgive your sin, as you see in front of you. And here, well, hold on, the Muslim, they will say he's lying. It's in the front of you in the screen. Isn't it? What kind of a prophet he promised you if you give him money, Allah forgive your sin? You tell me. This is what scam is about. If I promise those who they are listening to me now, if you make a donation to me, God will forgive your sin. Obviously, I'm lying to them. Why God will forgive your sin? What you did? In Christianity, we don't do good because good, you know, because good will delete our sin. No, our sin is still there. It's Muhammad who taught them that. You can bribe God by money. Why God he need money? Isn't it Allah who is the king of the world and he is in control of the treasure? Why he don't tell Muhammad where to find some gold in the ground? A lot of gold. Why he cannot create even gold for him? It's okay, my friend. We are done for today. We will be later again here, you know, supposedly in a few hours from now, actually. But let us see how many views this video will have. If we have just little, then I might delay the second video, maybe for tomorrow. So I have a scheduled video, scheduled broadcast later. I think it's 1 p.m. my time, which is New York time. But if we don't have enough view of this video, then we will delay the other one, and we will shift it maybe for tomorrow. So I want to say thank you guys for being here. And I hope today we answer many many Abdul who they are ashamed of their cult, and they have no idea what to say to us. They have no idea how to answer. And I don't blame you to be in disability. You have a stupid God, stupid religion, God of the vagina vendor. You know, he's busy now. Your God, he cannot help you to answer me. He's busy making vagina. Have you ever heard of God? It takes him 1,000 years to soften the skin of a woman. Why? Your God, Allah, never heard of something is called Nivea? How you say to me that God, he say B is going to be, yet it takes him 1,000 years to soften the skin of a woman. And why? What this woman is about? She's made of, like, she's a she is alligator. 1,000 years to soften a skin. Why? She is Arabian. I am an Arab. We have a very tough skin, for my friend. 1,000 years. Go and take this woman to Thailand. They can make her look like a Barbie in 2 weeks, and they will make a male a female, and they will instill a breast for him, and they will install an ass for him. And your God taking him 1,000 years just to soften the skin. 1,000 years. Why? He's working in a slow mood. And if every woman need 1,000 years to soften her skin, and every Muslim will get 72 women at least, when Allah is going to finish his job? My friend, your God is funny. I like your God. I wish I can purchase one. Do you know where I can get one like this? I will put him in the front of me, and I open my camera to YouTube, and imagine how many people will subscribe to watch Allah soften the skin of a woman. He have her in the table, and he is spending 1,000 years softening the skin. My friend, send that woman to me. I will soften her skin in 2 weeks maximum. Even if she is, she have a skin of a goat. Why she need 2 weeks? I mean, she 1,000 a year. What she's made of? There's machine, they can soften the concrete in 2 seconds. Concrete. Can't Allah buy one? All right, my friend. Thank you very much for being here. Don't forget again to subscribe to this minds.com, as you see in the screen. Minds.com, Christian Prince. This is all. This is more stable account than all the other account, YouTube, etc., Twitter. So always, if you lose contact, you can always find me. And this is my other contact here, which is Patreon. But I prefer always if you guys subscribe to minds.com. If you don't mind, it take you a second, and logging in is very easy. You do not need even to create an account. Just use your Google account and you will sign in immediately. And this is a website where the owner of this website, they grant freedom of speech, which means they will not ban you unless you do something really badly wrong. So subscribe so we can stay always in contact, and always you know where to find me and how I can find you. May the Lord bless you all, and we pray that the Muslims, they will find the truth. And trust me, Muslims, we don't hate you, and we will never hate you. We are here fighter for the truth, not fighter against you, which means we are fighting for your benefit, not against your benefit. We are not against you. I do not know you. You do not know me. Nothing personal. It's just about salvation, my friend, and your God is nothing but a fake God. If your God is God, I don't want this God. If the heaven of Allah is heaven, I don't want that heaven. I think hell is more honorable from the heaven of Allah. So think about it, and you have a brain. If your God gave you the brain, use it. Let us see if your brain will make you accept the promises which is made by Muhammad. Is it real? Can it be real? Isn't it against the ethic of God to be a vagina vendor? You make women for us just to have sex with them, women we never met? Is that a reward, or this is an insult? Is that really what you want? You want to be a sex slave, addicted to slave for eternity? As the Quran says, fakihun, you will be busy having sex. Busy. Not busy reading books. Not busy earning knowledge. Not busy enjoying the wonder of God. No, busy having sex and 70 years orgasm. Read my books, educate yourself, and learn the truth, and the truth will set you free. Thank you very much, and may the Lord bless you all. Christ is Lord, Islam is false. Amen to that. See you.